Well, it's another crazy late night wild camp. It's actually 10:30 at night and I've decided to go camping. But to be honest, it's the only time I could get out today. And as you can see, it's really foggy. Just come up the hill and it's foggy as hell, which makes it even more difficult to see where you're going. But I'm meeting up with Lee and Ray, a couple of guys who's already set up camp during the day and probably having a fire on the go by now, would have thought. I've got a survival aid bivvy with me. Basically keeping it nice and simple so I can set up quick. A little ground sheet, bivvy, sleeping bag and mat, and that's about it. So it's a quick one today. I'm now in the wooded part. They're in here somewhere. I think it's going to be quite warm tonight. It's only dropping to about 7 degrees. It's been raining all day, so the ground's soaking wet. Right, where are these guys? Down here somewhere. Very quiet. So, it's when my sticks are leaned against a tree. One of my other videos. It's a late night walk and cook. Lean sticks against a tree so you can find your way out. But I'm not going out today because I've got my sleep system. Even if I can't find the guys, I'll sort it out. But I'll be able to find them. I don't know. Seriously boggy. Flooded. I think I found him. Proper stealthy. Over there. Get off my land!
Hello!
Here's Lee's setup. He's got the 3x3 multicam tarp and gotten already. What bivvy is that?
USGI.
USGI.
It's a copy of the US Army bivvy system.
Yeah. It's kind of cool. Pretty simple. Lightweight. That's a fire. Believe it or not. I've just walked into a guide rope. Now let's have a look at Ray's setup. He's got the bright green. What's this? Andes tarp. How much was that?
£16, I think that was.
16 quid? Bloody hell. 16 quid, you can't go wrong.
The hammock was 18 quid off Amazon.
Oh yeah, I got one of them. I think.
With the tarp that's on the floor there.
Oh right, no, it's a bit different to what I got. Hammock set up. And I've just gone over here. Here's my survival, I think it's survival aids bivvy. It's a double hooped bivvy. I haven't got my sleep system in yet. But I've got my Thermarest and snug pack sleeping bag and a liner. And I'm wearing my base layers, so I've got to be nice and toasty. Two tarps underneath. From Poundland, so just pound each. This bivvy's shorter than the Dutch Army bivvy. I found out that I could have got away with just one short tarp. Can't see much at the moment, but we're here in the woodland. Finally done. Almost time for bed now. But If it wasn't wet, I wouldn't bother with a tarp, but obviously there's a bivvy there. I bodged this thing together. It's not very waterproof, this one. It's a lightweight, cheap thing, but it's just to get in and out without making a mess. To save room inside the bivvy, I've got my bag at the back there with the waterproof cover around it. Stick just to prop the basher tarp thing up a bit. Probably won't be just a bivvy, but as I say, it's nice to have a bit of a roof over the entrance, which is Gore-Tex. There's a lot of them are. It's got a fly net, so I could zip that up to let some air in. In there, I do have the one season sleeping bag, that small thing, but it's quite warm actually. I don't think I'm going to need it. So that's the snug pack liner. It's a bit of a pain in the ass to get in and out of this thing because you've got to sort of wiggle in without laying on the wet stuff. I do prefer the one that opens up down the side, but it's something different. Plus this one seems to be warmer. I think it's because I've got this space here. Body heat warms the space up, keeping it warmer inside, whereas the Dutch Army one, it sort of drops down. And at night, if I take my arm out of the sleeping bag and touch the bivvy, you can feel the outside cold. So I've got that Poundland pillow, Thermarest reflective mat, cheap top. I could have the bag in there and use the bag as a pillow, but I've got a few bits in here. I've got a jumper in there if I need it, and keys and some earplugs and whatnot. So that's home for tonight. Raised in his hammock, leaves by the fire, and I'm wandering off in the woods. It's I think it's nearly 1 o'clock in the morning. Morning campers, it's about 6:30, it's 5 tonight. This little tarp wasn't much good, but the bivvy's waterproof. That was nice and dry inside. I actually got a little bit cold last night, woke up because it was chucking it down, I could hear it, but yeah, surprisingly a bit chilly. Guys are up. having their breakfast. I'm just going to have a coffee.
Currently outdoors, looking at Rickles outdoors, with his multitude of head torches and stuff on. It's about 6:30 in the morning. We're all up, raise up, eating breakfast, morning low.
I've got coffee on the go. Water pot, stove, simples. Packed away. It always seems like I've got more when I'm packing away, but just trying to rush everything back into the bag. Got all my litter and everything in there. Chair at the bottom. That's where I had the bivvy. Leave no trace, just scratch the ground up a bit. The other guys are packed away. It was a nice camp last night, even though it was a bit of a quick rushed one, it was quite good. There's a bit of a trowel here. It's funny because last night there was something over here, like moving about. See, it's all been scratched up, that's weird. Looks like something's dragged through and stopped near. And there's where the bivvy was. Guys. That's dodgy. Heading back now, back to the norm. So I'll say thank you for watching. Much appreciated. And I'll see you next time. Bye.